Welcome back to the channel, everyone. So this is a really exciting tool that's available from ChatGPT, but you need a VPN to use it. It's called Operator. It allows you to send an agent off across the web to do work for you. Is it any good? Is it useful? Let's have a look. Okay, so here we are in Operator, and you get to Operator through operator.chatgpt.com. All right, sorry, this is the professor from the future. I've just found something out. So if you're on your VPN and you go into ChatGPT, actually you can access Operator and Sora directly from ChatGPT. I hadn't noticed that, and I've been going through the website that I've just told you about, but actually you can just do it from ChatGPT, which is very cool. Okay, get on with the video. You have a list of your recent searches here, which is good. You can, if you set off a task, you can go away and leave it, and it will show you whether there's a task in process, and then you can have the create a new task. So what does it do? So what Operator does, it is opens a browsing window and then goes off and does things for you. And there are a whole lot of use cases for it that ChatGPT have created, and links to certain websites. So you can suggest a meal and it will look at all recipe. So set it going, and there you go. It's opening up the browser. Let's just make that bigger. It's opening up the browser. It's browsing to the website, all recipe, and it's now searching the recipe, looking for a 30-minute meal with chicken that has at least 4.5 stars, and it works itself away. See, it's doing a search. It added in chicken here to the search results for chicken, looking at the stars ratings, scrolling and identifying options. It's navigating itself. I'm not touching this at all, hands free. It's navigating itself around the website to find this chicken meal. Takes a few minutes. It's not super fast. I suppose it all depends on the search criteria. So now it's done chicken, it found loads. So it's now doing 30-minute chicken. So it went back, it had too many results, so it's gone for 30-minute chicken, and it's finding the results for that. And it's found one that's 4-star. So last-minute chicken dinner isn't going to work. There we go. 30-minute chicken main dishes. It's having to upload it. Searching through the website, it might produce spicy Thai basil chicken. So that's a 5-star, loads of ratings, and it's within the 30-minute. You can imagine, you can set this off, come back later, do some other work on your computer. You don't need to be sat on the computer, and it will find the appropriate response. So it's found one that it thinks is useful, and it's gone in just to check that it is within the 30 minutes. It has 4.5 stars, at least. There we go. I found a 30-minute chicken recipe with a 4.6 star rating, easy sesame chicken. You can check out the recipe here. You get a link, and it will take you to the specific site. It's cool, isn't it? Okay, so other things that is sort of built in, you can reserve a table. You can get tickets for the Miami Grand Prix on StubHub. Very US-centric, this. You can organize deliveries from Uber Eats, DoorDash, Instacart, identify local services. So if you want a cleaner for your home, you can do it from Thumbtack, Uber. Remember, this is not available in the UK yet, so you get very US-based responses. Go shopping on Etsy, Target, and eBay. You can find items on eBay. So rather than searching through things, it will find them for you. Book travel. Uses booking.com, find news, summarize the top political headlines for today. And it will do that through the Atlantic, the New York Post, Wall Street Journal, Market Watch, and Barron's. Yeah. So there's a whole load of built-in ones. But of course, the really interesting thing would be to use it in its own browser to go and do work for you. So one of the things that I regularly do is search for new equipment for my YouTube setup. So I will put in a prompt, normal prompting. So I've written a prompt. Look at the latest reviews for fixed YouTube cameras and give me the details of the best buys for 2025. Click it off and it opens up the browser. So it's got a number of things to do. So it's got to do YouTube camera reviews. So it's searching Bing. It uses Bing. Best fixed YouTube cameras 2025 reviews. There we go. It's found 7 best cameras for YouTube winter 2025. Going through those. So it takes a bit of time. It's reading these websites to find out the best camera. And of course, you can do all of this yourself. You can absolutely go through Google and search, identify the websites that do camera ratings, click through, find the best cameras. But let's see if we can get this AI agent to do that work for me. And I guess the thing is, think about what you do in your everyday work, what you do in your life, whether it's searching for new products, searching for places to stay on holiday. And actually, just by asking operator, you can get it to do a lot of that web searching yourself. I use it quite a lot, and it saves me a significant amount of time rather than going through Google and searching and reading and then what have you. I'll do some other demonstrations in a little bit. Okay, so the best fixed YouTube camera for 2025 is the Sony ZV-1. Praised for its portability, fully articulated screen, and built-in vlogging microphone. Its fixed lens design makes it ideal for fixed setups. Other notable cameras include the Canon EOS R50 and DJI Pocket 2. Okay, so it's found what it thinks is the best, Sony ZV-1. Okay, so obviously I want to buy one of these cameras, but so it's given me 3 cameras, the ZV-1, the R50, Canon EOS R50, and the DJI Pocket 2. And what I've asked it to do now is please find me the best price for these 3 recommendations in the UK. So it's thinking about it. You can see up here on the left, it says I've got one task running. So it's gone to look for the best price, and interestingly, showed us a Copilot price. So Sony ZV-1, $463.94, I think I saw. Moving on to the next website. Now, I don't know if I would absolutely trust this, but it at least gives you a start, doesn't it? It at least gives you a place to look for the camera that you want and potentially the best price. They are 50. They've done 2 of them. And it's now looking for the best price for the DJI Pocket 2, which is one I don't really know. The other two, I'm not surprised that it's come up with that as a recommendation, but let's see what the DJI Pocket looks like. Ah, now it's found an error, site unavailable, unable to access the site. So now will it just stop or will it try something else? We'll see. So it says Amazon link for DJI Pocket 2 is unavailable. Should I try a different website? It's trying alternative links. It's tried several times. It's struggling. Can't see it doing a lot in the browser, to be honest. But at any point, you can sort of take control. And what I might do is just close that window. See if I can get it to finish up. Closed a window. It seemed to get itself a bit stuck. Let's see if by closing a window, it will be able to find the DJI Pocket 2 in the UK. There we go. It has now worked. So it got itself a bit stuck and now it's going in. So it's been asked about cookies. It's accepted the cookies, which is cool. You know, I don't want it to keep asking me about that sort of thing. And there we go. It's found me the 3 best prices. So the ZV-1 is 463p on Idealo. Canon EOS R50, $699 on Canon UK site, and DJI Pocket 2, $169 on Price Spy. Really cool, isn't it? Now, obviously, you saw I had to intervene once. It got itself into a little loop, but I was able to go in, close that particular window down that it was looping in, and it just went back and carried on. But that's cool. It's a cool use of this technology to allow it to go off and do things. Okay, so let's look at how it might do some other tasks. So I've created a prompt, check the SEO on the website, theprofessor.info, which is my blog site, linked down below, and report back to me on how it could be improved. Full screen, so you can see it better. But search into theprofessor.info. There we go. My new cookie. So hopefully I will be able to get monetized on Google AdSense. So it's exploring the site structure, checking content for SEO elements. There's me. Why I won't use Grok 3. You want to go and read that. Got categories of blogs. And so you saw that it got to a stage where it wouldn't allow it access and it just tried something else. I think that's really cool. I think it is really good at identifying problems and then finding a way around it. Okay, so it's given me some improvements. I think they are very general improvements rather than specific to this site. Ensure each page has unique meta description. They do. Keyword optimization, incorporate relevant keywords naturally within the content, internal linking. I think I can do more of that. Structured data, implement structured data for better search engine understanding. These adjustments can enhance the site's SEO performance. Okay, so I did ask it to go into the Wix editor, but my Wix account is on a different Google account than what is loaded into this, so it made it a little bit difficult. So I'm asking it to go to Ahrefs to see if it could look at the latest dashboard for this website and give me some advice on what to do. I think it will probably ask me to log in a second. So when you get to a login point, it usually hands it over to you. We get to sign in, so it's quite likely to now hand it over to me. I have to log into the browser, going to Ahrefs. So it's looking at my site. There's my URL. I have to say, wasn't looking at my site. What it's done is it logged me in because I logged in. Now I'm going to resume operator. So it will now have a look at my report. It's checking the site audit. And it knows what to look at, which is more than I do half the time. But it knows what to look at. Comparing my site. There'll be some of you on this call that are screaming at how appalling the site is. I'm sure. I'm learning as I go. There was a video where I set this site up. There we go. Improve SEO, fix broken links, add internal links to orphan pages, and resolve site map issues. So it's told me what I need to do. Let me see if I can get it to do some of those things. That would be very cool, wouldn't it? If I can log into my Wix account. I'm logging into Wix and it's sent me a code, which is good. We have lots of two-factor authentication going on here. It means I'm very nice and safe. I've logged into Wix. Finish up now. So now, hopefully, it is going to selected the right site. I'm going to the Wix Studio, loading the dashboard. I might have to stop this if I think it's going to crash my website. Doing this live for you, going into edit site. So Wix Studio seems to be taking longer than expected. It's coming now. I do find Wix a little bit slow sometimes, so maybe it's too slow for this. Loading again. I guess it feels slow because we've got a ChatGPT's web browser trying to access web browser from somewhere else. It's taking time. Here we go, it's trying again. Since we're making some progress this time. So it said that it might be a problem with the Wix Studio. So I will say, and it's offered me to explore alternative approach. So explore an alternative approach. Would you like to give me specific instructions for addressing the SEO issues identified in Ahrefs? So could you make suggestions, please, based on your access to the back end of the site? See what we get. I would expect it would go, there we go. Please provide detailed instructions each step. So what would have been really cool is if it had been able to go in and do all of that stuff. And remember, this is brand new. This is not something that is has been out for a very long time, and it will only get better. But it has given me clear instructions on what to do. Cool. Pity I couldn't have got it to work with Wix. Does seem like it is loading still. Cool. It just gives you an idea of the kind of things you can use Operator for. Okay, I don't want to make this into a massive video. As you can see, Operator, it's new, but it is very cool. Think about giving it a task to do that uses the internet. Now, one of the things I did was ask it to create me a PowerPoint presentation. It opened Canva and it created a PowerPoint presentation for me based on a prompt that I got from ChatGPT. And it was okay. It really struggled in getting the text in the right place, but it did create me 10 slides with the text on, which allowed me to then go and fiddle with it. So, you know, those sorts of use cases are real and can make life a lot easier. It's not quite there yet, but as a start in terms of using agents in this way, I think it's very cool. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, make sure that you give me a thumbs up, a like below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.